Dr. Noam Peleg from the Division of Gastroenterology in Rabin Medical Center in Israel. And on behalf of my co-authors, Dr. Boris Sapozhnikov, Professor Iris Dotan, Dr. Steven Shamah, Dr. Hemda Weiss, and Dr. Ariel Schwartz, I'm delighted to present our research entitled Neutrophil to Lymphocyte Ratio and Risk of Neoplastic Progression in Patients with Barrett's Esophagus. Patients with Barrett's Esophagus have an increased risk of development of dysplasia and adenocarcinoma over time. Accordingly, endoscopic surveillance has a critical role in prevention and early diagnosis of esophageal adenocarcinoma in this population. To date, there are several risk factors that are associated with progression to neoplasia in patients with Barrett's esophagus, including low-grade dysplasia at diagnosis, long segment of Barrett's esophagus, severe gastroesophageal reflux disease, active smoking, and family history of esophageal adenocarcinoma. Neutrophil to lymphocyte ratio is a sensitive marker of local and systemic inflammation and may predict prognosis in many types of cancers, including esophageal adenocarcinoma. However, the role of neutrophil to lymphocyte ratio in premalignant conditions like Barrett's esophagus and its ability to predict progression to high-grade dysplasia and esophageal adenocarcinoma was not known. In our study, which included more than 300 patients with Barrett's esophagus, we observed the correlation between neutrophil to lymphocyte ratio and baseline histology of Barrett's esophagus, and we showed that patients with high baseline neutrophil to lymphocyte ratio, meaning above 2.4 at the diagnosis, had a higher rate of progression to high-grade dysplasia and esophageal adenocarcinoma during follow-up. More specifically, neutrophil to lymphocyte ratio was associated with threefold increased hazard of progression to high-grade dysplasia and esophageal adenocarcinoma in this population. And even more than that, in a specific subpopulation of 240 patients with non-dysplastic Barrett's esophagus at a diagnosis, patients that have neutrophil to lymphocyte ratio above 2.4 had more than twofold increased hazard of histologic progression during follow-up, even upon adjustment to other known risk factors associated with histologic progression in Barrett's esophagus. We believe that our finding may have an important effect on endoscopic surveillance in patients with Barrett's esophagus. According to our findings, patients with neutrophil to lymphocyte ratio above 2.4 and at diagnosis can be considered for specific surveillance program with shorter interval between endoscopic sessions, even if they don't have other previously known risk factors that found to be associated with histologic progression in Barrett's esophagus. We hope you find this was interesting, and thank you for your attention.